I will tell you as it was told to me, as told by the elders to my grandfather. When a young person was seeking his way, looking for answers to guide him along the good red road of life, the elders took him up to the mountain and put him up for 4 days and 4 nights. No food, no water, just his buffalo robe and the chanupa, the sacred pipe, and himself.
Be quiet!
This was called the Hamblecha, to seek for a vision, a dream to show him the way.
Is your name No Ears?
I am Eagle Boy. Who speaks to me? The spirit?
There are other mountains you could have picked. Why here? All night long we have to hear you sing, cry, talking to yourself. What are you, crazy?
I come seeking a vision.
I come seeking a vision.
You are not worthy of a vision, Eagle Boy.
You will not give up this quest. You are a warrior.
Grandpa, did he get eaten?
Did he get eaten?
Eagle Boy.
I don't remember now.
Grandpa?
It was told to me so long, long ago by my grandpa, who heard it from Black Elk, who heard it from his great-grandpa, who heard it from the storytelling stone himself.
Bear Butte must have had him, yeah. I know it.
Well, he knew he had to go through many tests to find his vision. So he began to sing, to call on the helping spirits. And then... I will tell you what happened another day. Sometimes the stories come, and sometimes they go, just like that one over there.
Hey, what happened to you?
Nothing.
Looks like something. Something to do with that May little wounded?
Mom.
You know, if you want to win her heart, you give her the end of the bread.
Hey, give her the end of a loaf of bread?
Oh, look, old woman's secret.
Shh, I think I'm psycho.
Hey, you borrow some cash?
Oh, yeah, there's $1 million in casino money underneath my dresser. Just leave me a few thousand.
Whatever.
Hey, what's this? Fight?
Fell off a horse?
Yeah, you never been on a horse to fall off of a horse.
Mm-hmm.
Hey, listen. I need to talk to you, Shane.
What?
It's about Grandpa. He's getting old. He's been talking about, you know, taking the journey.
You've been talking about taking that journey for a long time.
He's almost 87.
Yeah. He told Eddie Tubles he was 102.
Yeah, he told this white lady looking for an Indian name last week that he was 49.
I'll be home later.
I know Grandpa Shane. This is going to be his last powwow. He wants to go to New Mexico to the All Nations.
Why?
He's a storyteller, one of the last old ones. People need him.
Can't you send an email? You're too old to go 600 miles.
Yeah, but you're old enough to drive.
Oh, no.
Oh, yeah.
Why me?
Because he don't want no one else. He wants you, Shane. He wants you to get him to the powwow.
Can't.
Can't?
I got things to do.
Like what? Summer on the res. What are you gonna do, get in trouble?
Volunteer work. Community service. Help my mother pick choke chairs. Anything but that.
Yeah, hey. Get me to the powwow. I'll give you my best pony, 1966 V8 Special. Its name is Many Miles with no muffler, but it runs fine.
I guess you got a point. Why not?
Damn. May, I have to ask you something.
What do you want to ask me?
I want to ask you, you know, if I could have that back. You see, I pawned a boombox up in Cena to get that. I owed Victor's blood some money for some smoke. They were gonna kill me, so I took the boombox up the pawn. And that's when I seen it, the ring. I'm gonna give it back to you, you know, at the end of the summer.
Hey, that you chasing a horse? What did I tell you about coming
here? What's going on, Shane? Victor wants his muzzle scar.
Look, you'll get your money.
You damn right we check
the boombox. The boombox won't mine either. Right, I need to pawn the ring back, just for a few days.
That Indian giver is just a myth, isn't it?
It is.
Then I'll keep it till you talk to the old man. You know, about going out with me.
What the heck's going on out there?
Hey, Shane, where's the box, bro? First you owe Victor money, now you took his tunes.
I told you I'd get it.
Tomorrow, or you gotta deal with the Vice Lord. You owe the dog soldiers money, blood.
Shh.
Or they gotta find you in the Badlands.
You're making your grandfather happy, Shane.
He said when I get him there, this truck is mine. How much you think I'll get for it over in Rapid?
Attaboy.
You gotta be kidding me. He's bringing his horse?
It's for the giveaway ceremony. Three Moons is his last pony. He wants to give him away at the powwow.
I tried to give away that horse before. No one will take it.
Hey, come on. It's gonna be fun.
It's gonna be the Trail of Tears.
Shh.
That's what it's gonna be.
It's what your father would have wanted.
Okay, hey, let's ride.
Get him there, Shane, please.
Rest. It is a fine pony.
What?
It is a fine pony.
How many miles to Albuquerque?
Many.
Many.
My heroes have always killed cowboys. I see. Got your war shirt? The man wears that shirt. Does that make him an Indian?
I am an Indian.
You're an angry Indian.
I don't trust any skin who ain't angry.
Right. The white man stole all our land. But for the rest of your life, you should wake up every morning and blame all your troubles on Custer and not even try to make a life. What are you doing?
Forgot something.
What'd you forget?
Forgot how far it is to Albuquerque.
We made a trade for a 1966 pony.
You can keep your 1966 pony, Grandpa. I really don't need this right now, okay? Got problems, man.
Ah, you're pitiful. The spirits told Eagle Boy.
I don't need stories, Grandpa.
Eagle Boy could do nothing but hang on for his young life.
See? I am a strong-hearted warrior, worthy of a vision. Stay strong. You'll receive your vision. You'll return to camp with wisdom and power. Help me. Help me.
Eagle Boy, what happened?
Thunderbird made a great storm. Lightning came out of his eyes. Eagle Boy tried with all his might to meet the trials of his hamblecia. Could he or could he not?
Well, you're the storyteller, man.
I will tell you tomorrow if I'm still in this world.
Yeah, come on, you can't leave me hanging.
I'm the storyteller, man. I can do what I want. New Mexico's that way, isn't it? You will learn what happened to Eagle Boy when we get there, and I tell it as it was told to me.
Grandpa.
They must be after Three Moons, my war horse.
No, they're after my ass.
Better off with my horse. Turn here.
That's not a turn.
Turn! found yourself in some trouble.
Maybe.
Tell an old man who's been around a while.
Nah, it's none.
Nothing.
Some stuff with a girl. It's like that, you know?
A girl and trouble. They often go together well, sometimes perfectly.
I owed them guys money. I went to pawn a boombox, a music box to get the cash. Then I seen this ring that made Little Wounded light. I forgot about the money. I forgot the boombox wasn't mine.
You got yourself in a big mess. Couldn't think about that girl without falling over sick, without doing crazy things.
I think we lost him.
So in love with that young girl, he thought he would die. But her father forbade him in his daughter's cap. Bluebird woman. She was so beautiful.
Thank you.
You see, in the old days, it was not so easy to win a girl.
Hey, Bluebird woman, here he comes again. High Horse from Spotted Tail's band.
There were many trials a man had to go through.
Hokola, Nichtika, eh?
Was there? Was not 2 days ago, High Horse, that you came to my camp with a fine pony. Now you come with two.
Because I'm going to die, and I wish for you to have these excellent ponies.
Why are you going to die? I have heard of no war with the Crow.
I am going to die if I cannot have your daughter, Bluebird Woman. I'm going to walk into a Crow enemy camp and throw away my life.
Do you own a death song?
I do. A strong one.
Good. Go sing it. Don't come back.
Father has not given me away, yet you still return again and again.
Tonight, you will find me and my pony by the river. We will run far away, High Horse and Bluebird Woman, like two fingers crossed.
A fine woman does not run away with a man.
What must I do? I brought many horses, but your father sends me away. Do you not see I'm beginning to walk upside down like a Hioka?
I am a Lakota woman. I want to be one.
Tomorrow I go run the buffalo with the uncles. You must watch our daughter as a hawk watches a mud swallow.
A father fears his youngest will run away with the young man? Never. She thinks too highly of herself, like her father.
She thinks so highly of herself, I believe she might want to be stolen.
Did you not once steal a nice fat woman from a lodge across the Cheyenne River?
Did she not want to be stolen?
She was getting old and thinner. There was no one trying to win her.
Tonight you will tie her hands to her bed.
Aye, hey, are you drinking white man's water?
I will watch the teepee door until the sun.
You're a foolish old man.
I once had a fine friend named High Horse. Our mothers taught us to ride by tying us to one pony together and letting it run. When High Horse fell, I fell. We hunted buffalo. We sang war songs. Now, my friend is gone.
I am here, you fool.
No, your body sits here. But your spirit chases a girl up the Cheyenne River. Like a man chasing a ghost pony, never to be caught. Find yourself another woman, One whose father is not named kills enemy.
When we were boys together, as you say, what was it I longed to be?
Tokalakiha, a kid fox warrior.
And you?
Uchasha Wakaki, a holy man, a wise man.
If you were such a man, and I believe someday you will be, what wisdom would you give to your friend High Horse?
Your father guards the teepee, you say?
Yes.
And all the men in the village are warned?
It is so.
Only a fool would attempt to steal the daughter of a chief in a camp warned as such. Or someone who's been kicked in the head by a buffalo. Or a Wanagi, a dark spirit from the gray beyond.
Red Deer, you are indeed a wise man.
They will run when they see you. The entire village will run for the Black Hills, screaming to Tungashlan. You will take your wife as easy as a crow takes beads from an old woman. Ah, darn.
I'm sorry, daughter.
Is there no man good enough for me?
Not by your father's count.
I hear you, Owl Woman. Someone will die tonight. And it will be the one who comes to take my daughter.
A spirit comes!
What is it? It's a Wanagi, a dark spirit. Offer it food.
Hokahei! Hokahei! Run! I'll meet all of you! Hokahei!
Perhaps he too has come for my daughter. Chase him!
Hokahei!
The village is chasing away a spirit. That is all.
That's it! Turn them up! It is still a way to be rid of such a spirit!
Yeah, I'm not so wise yet.
A crazy thing I've done.
It was useless. High Horse tried everything to have that girl. But now that he was dishonored in such a way, how could he ever go back? He had no choice. He would ride now into the Crow enemy camp and die with honor. He was not afraid, for he had already thrown away his life.
What is this coming?
Yeah!
Like a vision they came. Crow ponies up the river. War ponies and buffalo runners and those of the Medicine Paint. Those that had been stolen from the Lakota long ago. And hope had returned to a people in need.
I, horse?
It is I.
Since the moon when the deer set their horns, we have tried to steal back our horses from the Crow. We have lost men, but we have never regained our ponies. Behold, a young man named High Horse.
You must know this. It was not ponies I desired, whether it be two or great herd. I wanted a son, High Horse. A son who was a true man and a doer of great deeds. Join roads with her. Be happy.
The fire I've lit for your daughter will never go out.
That's how it was told to me. Exactly as it was told to the old ones before me, and must be told in the same way or it loses its power. High Horse won his woman with honor, yeah?
Times change, Grandpa.
Times maybe. Not people. The 66 pony is thirsty.
No, this can't happen. We have a half a tank.
Sometimes the gauge doesn't work.
Why didn't you tell me?
Because sometimes it does. When it rain.
What, the spirits tell you that?
No. The bullet I got in my hip in France tells me that. Hurts like hell when it's gonna rain. You must find some gas. Take three moons, the Dun Horse.
I was right.
Trail of tears.
Come on, man. Let's go! What's the use, Grandpa? He's lame anyhow. And guess what? We're screwed.
Shut up and pray. Thunder beings. They speak to an old man. Listen. It happened many summers in the past. In the village of the Agwasasne Mohawks, the great Haudenosaunee. He was a thunder spirit, you see. And he had watched her all summer long.
Yeah.
He fell in love with the woman down in the corner. But it could never be. A Haudenosaunee, a Mohawk, and he was a thunder being. Sky Woman spoke from above. She summoned the thunder spirit back where he belonged.
Sky Woman, I will turn into lightning and die in the ground below before I let her go from me. You for so long. I could not live another day without you. I know the way you walk to the river in the morning and clean your skin. I watch your longhouse until the last fire goes out. No man has ever loved a woman as I love you.
But you are not a man.
I am spirit. I am thunder. You are human. We are one.
He has always been troublesome, Sky Woman speaks. Have you not been hearing the thunders more than usual?
Yes, Sir
Douglas. Has not the rain fallen greater than before, making the corn grow tall?
It is so, Sky Woman.
Still, speak, Sky Woman. If you wish to return to the Haudenosaunee, go, walk that way.
But if you wish to remain here, in the land of Sky Woman, take my hand.
Choose to stay with this one who will love me more than any husband could below.
She was happy there in the land of the Sky Woman, living among the thunder spirits. The wind creatures were sent down to gather food for the woman so that she could eat as her own kind.
Perhaps a woman does not have all she needs. Today, I can bring for you a fine dress, one made from the dust of the sun itself. My mother can weave for you a shawl like you have never seen. It will be made from the sun and stars.
I am content here, husband. Only I wish that our longhouse was not so small.
It is not large enough for a spirit and his wife?
It is large enough for a spirit and his wife. But not for the spirit's child who is coming.
Never were two beings in such deep love. Two worlds had become one.
Sky Woman, you are the clan mother of all. But now, you are going to be a grandmother. Speak, Sky Woman. Please.
A woman from the land below cannot give birth to a child here in this sky world. She crosses the water, must return to her Mohawk people, and raise the child among its own. Thunder Spirit, we must all lose what we love sometimes. It is the way. If you truly love this woman, deliver her back to her people now. She crosses the water. You will raise a boy down below. He will lead a good life. But if anyone should ever strike this child, you will lose him.
Please, remember me.
Will you watch over me and our child?
Always.
Daughter.
I have come home.
Who took you from us so long ago? Who did this to you? I will dig up my war axe from beneath the tree of peace and I'll find this one.
No man touched me, Father.
The child was born in the moon of big snows. His name was Thunderboy.
Oh, my grandchild is so full of mischief. I believe his father must be Abenaki or Ojibwe.
I told you, Mother, he is son of the Thunder Being.
Child, you were stolen during the storm by men from another tribe. Shame to speak the truth.
Now, where us? Hagat.
Look what you're doing!
Don't stop! Never touch my child. If anyone ever strikes him, he'll be taken away.
Spring came to the Mohawk people, and with it, the maple ceremony, giving thanks for the rejuvenation of Mother Earth.
Yes, your father says hello. I love you, Thunder Boy. Just as I love him.
boy was smaller than the Mohawks, and in many ways his habits were different than the ways of ordinary boys. Whenever a thunderstorm would approach, the boy would run out and laugh and play.
Squash. Well, I will keep my eyes on my grandchild.
Yato Tashini. Yato Tashini.
Do not cry, grandson. You are a good child, even if maybe you come from people we do not know.
Farther!
Up there is Sky Woman. We do not know who your father is.
No father.
Your father is not the thunder. Your mother went crazy when struck by lightning in the storm. She wandered lost into a camp of fishing people. Stop! No!
Thunder Boy was gone forever.
Thunder Boy! Thunder Boy!
It was known that the child returned to the Thunders. Heartbroken, she crosses the water would sing to him for the rest of her life whenever it stormed. And so did the generations to follow.
Get you there, okay?
If the spirits wish it so, it will be.
I'd say it has more to do with our gas money holding up.
It has to do with what kind of man you are.
What kind of man I am, huh? You ask me a little wounded father, he'll tell you I'm a loser. You ask Victor Two Bulls and his bloods, they'll tell you I'm a chicken running like...
It has been said that the young people of today are our warriors of tomorrow. I look at you and say, we're in big trouble.
You know, sometimes you can be a mean old man.
You don't understand your own power.
I don't have any power.
Do you even know what power is?
Money? A gun, maybe? They both make people move. That's power, isn't it?
No, that ain't power. That's pitiful. Do you know what you're doing?
Right now? Driving Miss Daisy.
Who the hell is Miss Daisy?
See, you don't know everything.
It's a damn good thing you do, because we're really far from home.
have begged, I have prayed, and I have starved. And they give me nothing. The spirits don't listen. They ran me off the mountain.
He must go back up.
I have no more knowledge now than when I first went up. No vision for me.
Then go home.
Wisdom, power, it comes from within. Within the soul of a man, Shane, when he realizes his relationship in the Great Circle, his oneness with the universe and all its powers. When he realizes that at the center of the universe is a power greater than himself. This power cannot be worn like a shirt. It cannot be carried like a gun. It's within.
Mosquito.
Yeah, he didn't kill it.
No. They used to call the bear grandfather. He was the first medicine man. He knew what roots to dig for different sicknesses, eh? Men weren't supposed to hunt him. One day, some hunters did. They were hungry and went against their beliefs. Killed the bear. And they tried to cook him. His ashes went up. Became mosquitoes.
That's how it happened. As it was told to me...
By Fool's Crow. Who heard it from Blackout, who heard it from his great-grandfather.
How'd you know? I never told you that story.
No.
Who did?
My father.
Yeah. They never should have killed that bear. He was a good boy, but like many, he wandered off the Red Road.
Was it drunk?
Do not speak like that of your own father.
He ain't my father no more. His choice, not mine.
The Red Road is hard to travel in these times, grandson.
Hey, brothers. You all heading to the All Nations?
Yeah.
Cool beans, cool beans. Me too. What tribe?
We're Sioux. Pine Ridge, South Dakota.
Hey, all right. My great-grandmother's grandmother, well, her aunt, she was one-third Kiowa.
Ah, Kiowa. Strong nation.
Yeah. Hey, could I hitch a ride with you, brothers?
No. No room, man. Towing a horse.
That's cool, man. Hey, maybe I'll catch you at the powwow.
Wanna be?
Maybe he's trying to be connected.
They stole our land? Now they want our sweat lodge?
Their fathers stole our land. Long ago, it was said, the white man would look on in disbelief as his sons and daughter began to adopt the Indian way, to learn what their fathers didn't understand. Yeah. He's a wannabe. He wanted to be connected.
How come you didn't stop?
Well, we gotta make the powwow, Grandpa. Man, when was the last time you seen a white man stop and pick up an Indian out here?
Long ago.
It was told among the Kiowas that there lived a brother and sister who loved each other as any brother and sister, though they looked different and were.
The boy's name was Teha. And he had been captured from the whites many years before. His sister's name was Talks-a-Lot because, well, she talked a lot. But he loved her, and she loved Tehan as her own brother.
Broken Lance.
Someone told me you were with the men up on the canyon wall.
Hello, Tehan. Your head, it is on fire.
Do not insult my brother.
Sister, please go. Behind it.
When will someone learn that he is one of us?
When will a woman see that her brother has skin like the belly of a frog? You've stolen our lands. Now you wish to steal our ways? Go!
Bear Rolf took me for his son. You insult his honor by insulting me. For this I will fight you.
Your father's Kiowa. You are a Tehan, a Texan, captured from the whites. I have dreams of your red scalp hanging in my teepee.
I remember the white man's ways. I do not wish them for my own.
Your blood is not our blood. You must leave the Kiowa. If I see you when the sun returns tomorrow, my knife won't stop where it has today.
Go!
Dion. The one is only angry because he let his father's ponies run away. Many colts lost in the canyon. And now he is afraid to chase them because the white men are everywhere. Do not hate Broken Lance. It is hard to trust any white man.
Sister, Beethoven, I am leaving. You must not.
I will return, but only with the runaway colts, to prove that I am true Kyle. If I do not return, remember me always as your brother.
Easy there, savage.
Hold it there.
Ain't no savage. Damn, that's a white engine.
What's your name, boy? Name?
Yeah, you remember that word, huh?
Name? My name is Tehan.
I'll be damned. That's him. That's a red-headed Kiowa they talk about at Fort Sill. He's one of us. Gonna be all right now. Bring up that bow.
Get him!
Get him up this ridge.
Tehan found himself far from the Kiowa world he had been raised in,
The officers told him he was free now, rescued from captivity. But Teha knew what freedom was and where he belonged. Morning, and it was not here among the Long Knives.
Hey, Texas Red.
Colonel, he wants to see you over at the quadrangle.
You know them better than anyone, Red. If we push them to the river, do they cross or go up into the Brasada?
I cannot remember much of how it was.
They're going to surrender to Fort Seal or be pushed north and off their lands. I need you, Red. I saved your life from the savages. I need you now.
They will never go north. They are not cowards, like some. I will ride alone to their camp. I will convince them to gather at the fort.
You leave this fort alone, and you are one dead, red-headed Injun. Am I understood? Come on, son. Show us your rabbit dance. I'll give you cognac.
Stake ourselves to the soil. Fight to the death.
There are too many. We have too many elders and children.
Then you go north. I stay, and I die, like Kiowa.
I am war chief. We go north now.
Not I. One of us is a prisoner at Fort Sill. Can we move our camp and leave him forever to the white men?
He is a white man. He is home. I will fight against him and win his scalp.
This is his home. I know my brother. He is trying to return, but cannot.
Tehan was a good Kiowa. But all tribes must lose a warrior for the sake of the people.
He is not just a warrior. He is my brother. Well, no man raise a war party to go free one of our own. Was not Tehan captured from the whites and raised as our own? Has he not hunted with you men and smoked with the elders? Has he not proved himself loyal to the Kiowa? How many times could he have returned to the white men? His heart is with us.
Talks a lot. Talks too much.
Because his blood is not our blood. We turn our backs on him now. If no man will fight for one of our own. Then I will.
I will not run. And I will not stay here to be killed like a dog. I go into the white fire. If I die, I die there. If I return, I return with Tehan. This woman speaks the truth.
Chief raised a war party for me?
No.
Who did?
Forever they would speak of the woman who had raised the war party for her brother and brought him home, leading their father's cults.
Look! Tehan has returned!
Kyle welcomed Tehan home with honoring songs.
There is no choice now. We must keep moving. We'll find a good place in the north.
I stay and I fight so the women can reach the north.
Then I do also. Who stays with Broken Lance and fights for the Kiowa?
Tehan, you must travel north with us.
No. Broken Lance is right, sister. Someone must stay and keep the whites back, or they will never stop chasing. You must go have children and keep the Kiowa strong.
Die here, Tehan. You could have survived as a white man.
But I am a Kiowa. My sister stood for me. Now I stand for her.
Then let us make war, brother. If our blood spills, it spills together, and then returns to the same mother.
So Tehan fought for the people his heart belonged to. He truly was a Kiowa, and he passed into legend as the great red-headed warrior.
I really appreciate it, man.
I can almost smell the fry bread. We're not far.
I'm really hoping they give me an Indian name this year. Oh, you're bringing your horse to the powwow. How awesome is that?
What?
The horse is good medicine to the Lakota, as I understand it.
Mm.
Hey, I bet you can talk to your horse.
right? You can understand him, he can understand you. Like brothers, brothers of the wind.
Hey, Grandpa, you think it's Gandhi picked him up hitchhiking?
I know this guy from Houston was adopted at the powwow last year. An elder did the ceremony and everything. Maybe I'll get adopted this year.
Hey, $300, we'll adopt you. And give you an Indian name.
Knock it off.
Sorry, man. I'm really tired.
That must mean Coyote, the trickster.
They walk together. Double trouble.
Been 2 days since we ate. Where are we gonna find some meat?
There's a white man in Santa Fe. A lot of cattle. We could cheat him out of a good meal. Some whiskey, some smoke.
They like to bet gold on horses, the white men. I'll bet him some gold, and my horse will beat his in a race.
What horse?
One that I have in Tuba City.
You got no horse in Tuba City.
You don't know that. But when I bet him a sack of gold, he'll give me one of his horses to go get my horse in Tuba City.
And then we eat the horse.
You're clever, Ink Tommy.
Yo yo,
ah eh,
ah eh,
ah
eh, ah yo,
ah yo,
ah yo. Oh, Tunka.
Grandfather Stone, you who knows everything. We are Coyote and Iktomi the Spider. Our bellies are full and we are happy.
What Iktomi means, Grandfather, is we are hungry and miserable. We have not eaten, and we might die out here. And if we die, who will show the people what not to do by doing it?
Yeah.
Do you offer tobacco? Got this old bone. Go away. This knife is all I own. I stole it away from a Pawnee. Go east.
The old man looked good, didn't he?
What is age? What is he now? 10, 20,000 years?
Oh, more than that, Yodi. He is the rock.
Yeah, he is. Look.
Let's feast.
Where's my knife?
But you gave it to Old Man Stone.
Go get it.
Well, you go get it. You gave it to him.
That's why I can't go get it. You can't.
You can't trick a trickster, Coyote. You go get it, Junka.
Grandpa, I was so hungry. I'm so humbled in your presence that guess what? I forgot my knife. Did you say something? Of course not. You are a stone, and I am crazy for talking to a stone in the middle of the desert. But that is my way. So I take my knife. And it is over. How hate you, Tualo. Goodbye.
No, it is not over.
Yeah.
Hey, they got cable.
You ain't staying here.
Why not?
I'm gonna get some coffee.
Hey, no cream in my man. I'm a vegan. Thanks. Thank you.
Oh, come on, Grandpa.
Eagle Boy had now gone 3 days and three nights with no food or water, but he had yet to receive his vision. Hunger he had known before and could withstand it. His robe shielded him from the cold, but it was thirst. Thirst that tested the strength of his mind, his body, and his spirit. The only vision coming to him was the vision of running water. Water. Water.
Wakantoka, Creator, thank you for making such beautiful water. Water that I must not drink for another day and night. Great vision.
I am Hehaka, the elk. The one woman cannot resist when I sing. You can drink from this water, so say the spirits.
No, wait!
Unkchekula lives there, the snake. She keeps the water for herself. You slay her and take her heart.
I may drink the water?
You may have anything you want.
Day and night on this mountain, and to return with a vision that gives me strong medicine.
Go toward the sun, two-legged, and you will find the cave of a beautiful woman. Only she has the arrows that can kill Unkchekula.
Unkchekula was real, And Hehaka the Elk spoke the truth. If a man could slay her and take her heart, he could have all he dreamed of in his life.
Seeking a vision, are you? They all come up here for that. Beggars.
The elk. The elk tells me if I slay Ongjekila, if I slay the water monster, take her heart, I return with strong medicine and have wisdom and power.
Ongjekila. She can only be killed with a walk-on.
I am the keeper of those arrows.
Have pity on me, old woman.
What will you give me, vision seeker? For my arrows that never, ever miss. Remove your fine buffalo robe.
Yes, you can have my robe.
It's not the robe that I desire. It has been many snows since I've been held by a man so young and strong. Please.
Maybe I don't need the water.
But you need a vision. Hehaka, the elk on you. Give me
for my old shell, but you would not give me pleasure when I was old and ugly, so you will not now that I am young and...
Beautiful.
Your mistake. The only way to kill Ongjekila is to shoot one of the four arrows through the seventh spot from her head.
Seventh spot from her head?
Behind the seventh spot lies her heart. Take it, but beware, it is like ice and fire all at once. Her heart will speak. It will ask you to do four things. You must refuse four times. After that, do as the heart asks. Is it understood? And let no eyes but your own ever look upon the heart, or it shall be destroyed. And with it, the power is given to he who kills Ongjekila.
Guiade,
many before Eagle Boy had tried to hunt Ongjekila. They were all blind now, or dead. But Eagle Boy had the four Wakan arrows. And so he waited.
I do not fear you. Come get me, Ongjekila.
Cry from the water.
Let me see you, evil one.
Thank you.
Come back, Umchekila! Do you not see a brave man standing here? Come back here, Umchekila!
I don't want to say anything, but that is a bummer of a closure.
It ain't the end. Tell him, Grandpa. Tell him what happens.
Does it matter? Does it matter if the stories are no longer told? If there's no one to keep the dream?
Hey, what did you guys think of Dances with Wolves? Hey! What's up with that, man?
Hang on!
Rednecks after us?
Indians.
Indians? We are Indians, aren't we?
Don't lose my horse!
Dude, this is so not what I had in mind. Can you let me out?
Stone sinking down into the dark water he traveled, where forever is now and yesterday is today, where we are no one but the story of ourselves. This is how it was told to me long ago by my grandfather, who heard it from his great-grandfather. And I will tell you what happened tomorrow, if I am still in this world.